Men and women, you're here today because you are the best of the best. Today, Canada's life hangs in the balance. Can you save Canada from the alien menace? And if so, are you willing to throw your lives on the line for a country that has done nothing but slow us down in this campaign? That's a ridiculous question. No country has slowed us down in this campaign. We only have ourselves to blame. Now it's time to pay back the world that has supported us in full. We are defending our home base, and these aliens are not going to get the satisfaction of terrorizing our population. Now let's do this thing and go home. Anyway, that was the motivational speech before the terror mission that kind of makes or breaks my campaign here. Also, No! Ow! You might notice that there's an counter or an counter in the corner
the
of this video.
Drop site for this operation will be in Canada.
And I'm basically
gonna...
The aliens
are continuing their incursions into highly populated areas. We can't allow further civilian casualties to spread panic in the region.
I have to consciously make an effort not to say or when I'm thinking, and I just did it right there. It's so hard. It's gonna be a difficult, it's gonna be a difficult challenge for me. It's so ingrained in my mind that I just don't know what to say. Maybe I should just take my time with talking. Those are some wicked shoulder pads you got going on there, Kelshmo. Oh dear God, it's the graveyard. I didn't even register what map it was.
Engage hostile targets. Watch your fire out there. We have civilians on the ground. Repeat, civilians are in the AO.
Boots on the ground. Pants on the ground. These aliens kind of caught me with my pants on the ground a little bit. So we have some choices here. We basically have to figure out what the best way to go about saving everybody is. And that's mostly throwing scanners everywhere and getting an idea of what the enemy count is, more or less. Who has all the scans? Who has all the scans? Ronan has a scan. Kelshmo, I think, has a scan. Yes, and you have two long-range bombard scans. Now for the scout. Which way do we want to go? Do we want to go right or do we want to go left? What's easier to deal with? We also have to set up Maseko for rockets. And, you know, the engineer for grenades. Where is Watson? There he is. He can get on heavy cover. Lots of people can get on heavy cover. Let's go ahead and move up to here. Let's just start scouting out in a direction. Oh, no contact. Interesting. All right. Well, then we're committed. We're going this way. And we're going to scan out beyond the sea here onto this street to see if we can hinder the aliens' progress and also get an idea of what we're up against. Chrysalids, of course. I mean, this is a terror mission, for gosh sakes. What I expect. All right, Ronan. Now, Ronan's going to want to go... I don't know if I want to go here. I mean, the scout's already committed. Yeah, if I reveal anything on my left flank, then I'm kind of done for, aren't I? I'll just have to scan from here. So we'll scan over this side. Now, scanners do actually still prevent civilian deaths. Anybody... I did it again. I can't stop. I won't stop. Okay. That stupid counter is going to... be the death of me. Thin men, of course. So anyway, yeah. The battle scanners still prevent civilian deaths in the fog. So that's something we don't have to worry about so much. Now, who do we want to go for first? Chrysalids or thin men? Well, I suppose it would depend on whether or not the thin men activate this turn. This would be a very good place for a rocket if we wanted to take out those thin men in one fell swoop. I think we should try and do that if at all possible. I think we're pretty safe. We don't know if there's a pod in that back corner. If there is, then we are kind of short-staffed to deal with it.
Enemy in sight.
Ah, chrysalids inside the building. And we do not have Ronan. Thank God it's only three. We can deal with this. We have grenades for this. It's good that we got the... Damn it! It's good that we have the pods out of the way now. You're killing me here. Okay. Now, Kelshmo. Or Simons, I'm sorry. You're not Kelshmo. Kelshmo's still got his shots, too. That's good. He's going to need to use them. Now, we want to move Simons up. To deal with this chrysalid menace, we probably want to go ahead and shred one of them. Whichever one's easiest to shred. and then make explosives a lot more appealing to us. Okay. Can you do this for me, Watson? We might want to get you in cover so you're... We need to kill these things this turn. They're going to be able to kill people, so we don't really have a choice. We have to end their miserable existences. 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 Very good. Very good show. All right. Now let's finish this off. Kelshmo, take him down. Take that one down, please. Ooh, not a good day to miss, buddy. This is not what we need or deserve. That's the shot you needed to make earlier. Black Monk. Thank you, Kelshmo. You did your best. You know, A1 is not a guarantee. That's for sure. A 92 is also not a guarantee. Jeez Louise. We want to probably run and gun that. Maybe shoot with Maseko instead of steadying if we can't kill it with a shotgun. I don't know if I'm going to activate anything else. I'm outside the sight ranges for those chrysalids and those thin men. Then again, I don't know if there's any more pods within the building, but I think we would have revealed them if there weren't, or there were. I really just need to get a few steps closer for this to be effective. Hmm. Oh, Black Monk, what do you want to do? Yeah, you're not at all guaranteed to kill this thing. I mean, you don't have a good crit on it. Yeah, we will run and gun.
Hunt him down.
If only because we have to.
Headed there now.
Okay, good. No more activations. This should be 100. You're close enough. Come on, show me the money. Oh, just barely. You have CCS, though, actually. You have CCS. God damn it. Well, that was less of an... it doesn't matter. Okay, we can't steady. We'll make sure... We gotta guarantee this thing's death. Hello, floaters. I wasn't ready for you. But we're never really ready. Okay, that was pretty ballsy of them, I guess. Sweet Muton Lord and Savior. That's bad. We're gonna have to use the rocket now. Luckily, these flanks are pretty easy to get. Okay, alrighty. This is happening. We have a Muton. Oh my goodness. We have a sectoid, a Muton, a floater, and three other floaters on the side to deal with. This is gonna get very hairy very fast. If we are not careful, this could pretty much be the end for us. We need to prioritize here who we want to try and take out. Ronan McGrath, probably going to run you this way. Oh, actually, you know what? I should run him here so we can take out both of them at once. That's definitely a good plan. And then the scout can maybe handle that other floater.
Head in there now.
Ronan, you got two shots. You're going to use them appropriately. Damn it! Okay, take the first guy out. And then take the second.
Hostile eliminated.
Come on, Ronan. This is what you were born to do. Hell yes. Alright, for some reason, my recording is having some issues, so I'm actually going to go ahead and take a little second here. Sorry about that.
Copy that.
Okay, so apparently the music doesn't come back when you save and exit. Anyway, what I'm going to do right now is flank with Dale Watson this floater, and go ahead and take care of the Muton and other such messes with Black Monk. Even though it appears to me that the Thin Men are just in range... so I might not even be able to get a proper flank. I don't even think I can get a proper flank unless I do this, but I don't even think that would count because stepping out and whatnot. What I think might actually be better, and also I couldn't fix my recording issues. They're still here, as very apparent. Now that's not good. That's not what you want. That's the closest rocket we're going to be able to get on that sectoid. And really... We can't do that even, because there's a civilian there, and I don't want to blow the civilian up. We'd be better off shooting this Muton, but as evidenced by the yellow marker, there is somebody nearby. Is there? Are you sure? I don't see anybody. That might be our best bet, but it says I can't do that, because there's apparently a civilian. Where? Which one? Who am I hitting? Oh, the battle scanner, right. That's a friendly unit, I forgot. So, it's really dependent on whether or not we can kill this floater and this Muton. And if I put my rocket right in between them, that might work. We'll see. That sectoid's a problem, because he does need to die. Because if he doesn't die, that's a dead civilian, and I don't want that on my hands. But first, before we do anything, we are, of course, going to have to handle this with Dale Watson, hopefully. Now, it's not guaranteed to bring this guy down. But it did, so, hey.
Nailed him.
Don't have to worry about that anymore. Oh, we can flank with the gunner. I forgot that was a thing. Yeah, go ahead and do that, Lucas Simons. Why don't you take that Muton down a peg, if you would so kindly. Oh, God. If you can, even. Well, at least apply the hollow. Very good. That Muton is as good as dead if Black Monk has anything to say about it. Maybe even Kelshma has something to say about it. Hopefully. Now, where do we want to put Kelshma is the question. Do we want to use smoke? I mean, the problem is the aliens are going to be more likely to shoot at the civilians than they are at me. Now, okay, so I can get rid of these circles too. Let me just figure out where my sight range indicator lies. Actually, their sight might be blocked by this mausoleum. I'm not sure though. I don't want to risk that. That's a very scary play to be risking. I might just be more comfortable going here with Black Monk. And we still have grenades. Oh yeah, we have grenades. Engineer might be able to do some damage with those. Depending on his throwing range. What's your arm like, anyway? Not great. Let's see, what's your sideways arm like? And if we get you to that bench, do you think you can take out that sectoid's cover? Maybe. Maybe. We might just have a floater left. That's unfortunate, but that's just kind of how it's got to be. Okay. Well, let's all be that. Just because I don't want to risk activating any more aliens, we're not going to toy with that. 66. Eh, not great. I'd be a little happier throwing a grenade at him, and maybe at the same time... Oh, right, we can't do that. But we can fire a rocket if all goes out the window. We'll see. We'll see if it does. Now, Mr. Clean can possibly come over here and get a grenade on this sectoid, making things easier for Kelshmo to clean up. But I don't know if his range is going to be good enough.
I'm all over it.
Might be times like these I regret giving him that. Yeah. Gonna regret giving him that shotgun. But we can throw other grenades, which can do us some good. Though I'd like to save them for the chrysalids. And then Kelshmo can get back here.
Limito il movimento.
And either throw a smoke or handle somebody else. It looks like he's got only one shot on this guy. On this here... Muton? I don't know if I'm saying or not. I kind of forgot about that in the break. And what kind of shots do you even have, Black Monk? And that guy's not quite flanking you, which is good, but not great either. We can hit that floater somehow if we go here. Because I guess the stairs don't count as cover. Ah, I'm almost flanking both of them. That's so sad that I can't. Oh, well. We did our best. The AP... AP's not even going to reach him, really. We'd be better off throwing that with Monk. Well, since you only have one shot, but you don't have lock and load, I say go for it. 61's not the worst shot you've ever seen. And it's just good enough. It is just good enough to pull us out of the fire here. Why don't we go ahead and start moving up to deal with that sectoid? He's going to kill a civilian, isn't he? What can you do? I don't think you can... I don't think you can safely take care of this little dick. And even if you could, who would follow up? Can Jack Watson follow up? I don't even think he can see it. He can't even see it. He cannot even see it. Black Monk can see it, but he doesn't have a very reliable shot. He has a grenade that could potentially end it if the rocket doesn't finish it. But that's the question. Do we want to go after the floater? Do we want to go after the sectoid? And I don't know the answer to that question. We don't have a very good shot. I would try and grenade the floater. And then just leave the sectoid because the floater is just more threatening that way. Yeah? Yeah? Okay. Yes. Yeah, I know. It should be just the battle scanner.
Incoming.
It should be. I don't... Unless the civilians can turn invisible now, in which case, why not lend me that technology? Yeah, that's not great damage. But if we can't really move up right now, because if we did... then we just activate more messes that we don't need. Now, it's probably not as safe to fire a rocket over here because there's so many civilians, and if that goes wrong, it's gonna chunk them like Ukrainian giss. It's probably safer to shoot the sectoid with this rocket, and then we have another rocket to spare for the thin men next turn, depending on what they do. That floater is just gonna kill a civilian, and we are gonna have to deal with the thin men anyway, so I may as well try and take out a sectoid while we're here. I believe in you, Maseko. I believe you're not going to shoot those civvies. Very good. Anybody willing to maybe finish that off? I don't think Watson can. He's our only man left, so... Watson's just going to get ready to move out next turn and do some damage. And we'll flank the floater to scare him. We got Thin Mints. Hopefully those civilians move so I can rocket them. But they're not that smart. That Thin Man is way back there. And he's out of here. He's off to kill civvies. He's does not care about me. And that's the problem about Terra missions, is that they do not give a shit, the aliens. They really don't care. Oh, come on now. Be nice, be nice. I'm trying to save as many people as I can here. And those lids are still parading around. Wow, they've got some mobility on them. Okay. Yeah, that is an issue. Now, the civilians moved to safer places. Unfortunately, a rocket's only going to be able to take out that one Thin Man. We got to get aggressive, and we got to get aggressive fast. Now, Black Monk does not yet have his running gun again, but he can get a flank, and he can maybe take out that sectoid. You can do some cover destruction, actually, on that sectoid, if you're feeling inclined. Could even take some shots. We just have to figure out a safe way to do this. Oh, Black Monk, what's a good place for you to go? Your running gun is not up and operational. If we can kill everybody on this side, we're good, but if we can't, then we're in trouble. And we're in trouble. I mean, you're going to be able to get grenades from here, but you can also get flanked from there. You, I don't even know what to say about you. You can go into this full cover. You can handle that sectoid if we manage to actually get his cover out of the way. You're not really in a place to handle him right now. And that other guy, you could hollow. Maybe make the shotgun shot easier when we get to it. I don't know. We kind of just got to commit. We got to commit to being aggressive. We have a floater, 3 Thin Men, and a sectoid out there. That Thin Man and that floater are going to just kill another additional 2 civilians if we're not fast about this. And by fast, I mean we got to move Maseko up and get her rocket ready next turn to handle those 2 assholes. We think they are all that. And then we got to deal with that guy too. Don't even get me started on that. Now Black Monk has not a great shot against that guy. He's not in a good place to do that. Now hopefully Jack Watson can lob grenades to handle this problem over here. I hope he can. I think he would be able to, right? Sapper, all that jazz.
Moving.
He'll even be able to see somebody. Oh yeah, you can see that floater. Is he even flying? Oh, that dumb bunny. I'd love to take him out, but we do not have that option right now. Now, if I were really ballsy, I could try taking out both their benches, but I don't think that Thin Man's bench is gonna go. I mean, I could try it. But then again, that's not guaranteeing the sectoid's bench is going to go out either, but it's a ballsy play, and I think I might try to take it.
Throwing grenade.
Come on, Watson, I believe in you. Holy crap, well, that just killed the sectoid, so no need to worry about that. Now all our focus is on that Thin Man. Now either we holo suppress him or try to holo shred him. And in case this doesn't work and Black Monk is still exploded. He might be exploded all over that wall soon if we're not careful. So I think we might want to hollow him instead of shred him. Still got a pretty good chance to hit him. Now we still got to move up with Kelshmo and reload. He's not going to be able to get in the fight this round, but next round maybe. Oh, Ronan McGrath! That is correct. He still does have some sweet moves he could be pulling right now. How sweet is sort of in the question, and if we go up this way, we're gonna get chrysalid, so. That is a bummer. You can start saving people. But what good would that do? What good would that do? And then Maseko, where's she gonna go? Is she gonna use her rocket right now? Is she gonna shred right now? What's her game? Now she could shred and apparently not hit any civilians with this. That might be good, and save the last rocket for that chrysalid pod if it all goes tits up, but we should be able to handle that without a rocket. She does have mayhem, so this will do more damage than usual. Yeah, that's something to think about. We're not gonna be able to reach that floater with the rocket. We can just take out this one Thin Man right now, though. We can end his life. Okay, first Monk. Black Monk. Will you please take that thin man down? Good job. Okay. Two thin men, one floater left. Active. Ronan McGrath still has his move, his play. As does Dale Watson. Dale Watson can come in and do some business. We can also throw a scan through that, through this mausoleum to see what we're dealing with. And where would be the best place to do that at? We could just throw the scan from here, but I do want him to start getting back toward the action. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, those are civilians. I thought those were more pods. I mean, this had better be the last pod on the map. Okay.
Okay.
Watson, move up. Don't be afraid. We got this. Now that I think about it, that might have actually inhibited Ronan's running gun ability. Nah, not too much. Not anywhere he was gonna go or wasn't gonna go in the first place. Alright. Let's see what is the haps out here in the boonies. If we can get a scan out here, might be more difficult than it seems. And can I arc it over the building? I swear I had a pretty good one. Back here is kind of silly. Oh, that's on the... Oh, that's why. It's on the roof of the mausoleum. Yeah, that'll reveal quite a bit of information. It'll at least keep the chrysalids in check.
Let's have a peek.
Very good. So, let's get a little tally here. Let's check the chrysalid sight range, actually, too. See how far up the building we can get. Nah, no. I wouldn't go inside that building. You couldn't pay me to do that right now. We got four chrysalids. Three chrysalids? I thought it was four. Unless one got left behind. The CCS circles will reveal all. It looks like two. And then we have that other thin man. Lord knows where he went. We could try for the Shredder, but then we wouldn't have Masako for a rocket next turn. Ronan McGrath, and then where would we put her for a rocket next turn? Where would she be useful? She could get a rocket further up to deal with any other trouble. Ronan can maybe do some damage against that Thin Man, but I don't know. We need him back in action. We need him back soon.
Hunt him down.
All right, Ronan. Gotta be a hero.
Roger that.
It is hero time. This is what you were born for. Splattering alien faces all over the... Whoa, hello. We have another thin man out there. Ugh. And they are not happy, I'm sure. Well, we might even be able to get a Shredder on him too. 62% chance with a laser pistol. That's probably not going to finish anybody off. No, I wouldn't imagine it would. Damn. 58, 37, 25. These chances to hit are not great with Ronan, which is bad. But... if we shred, that pistol might be pretty appealing. And we can shred all of them right now with this shot if we do it right. So I think I'm going to confirm that rocket. I'll give it the go-ahead. That might be pretty useful.
Now this is gonna hurt.
Heck, we might be able to finish this with laser pistols if Ronan can make these shots, these clutch 50%. We might be able to finish a floater. We'll have two thin men, but that's two civilians pretty much dead this turn. 62, 60. Yeah, I think 62 is our best shot we have. I believe in you, Ronan. Ah, damn. Well, we tried our best. But they're flanked. They're scared. They're going to keep running. Run to the battle scanner so I can see you. No? Okay. Fine. That's good. That's dandy. Just kill that civilian. I didn't need him alive anyway. Oh, my God. Oh, jeez, it's a massacre. Bodies flying everywhere. Go home. Go home, you nasty sons of bitches. You cheating. Ugh. And here comes the fun. Oh, the fun did not arrive just yet. Okay, 13 is not so bad. If we can mop this up this turn, we're good to go. We might not be able to, but... okay, we're just gonna activate these chrysalids. We gotta finish this game off. We can get a shot on this guy for free. We can get a shot on another chrysalid for free. We can maybe rocket the chrysalids if the steadying isn't too bad. Well, Rona might just get surrounded, so we'll have to back him up. That floater, now, because we have Watson, what can you do? Actually, would it be better if we activated these chrysalids through here? So they went after Watson and not Ronan. So Ronan would have free reign to come up and take a couple shots. That's a good question. But I'd like to use the scout's Deadeye, but I don't think I can make him come in at that at a good rate. Yeah, we might just put him here.
I'm on the move.
We might just have him activate the crystals and pull them through.
Enemy troops.
Depending on what they want to do. Oh no, they're just going for civilians. Never mind. That wouldn't have made a difference. That's not what we want. Alright, Ronan. How are you feeling today? Now, your running gun is out of time. Or you're out of running guns.
Roger that.
But you can get a free shot on this thin man. Take him down. So do that, please. That's not good. Did he just get acided? No, he didn't. He's fine. That thin man's a problem. But if we can take care of that floater, we should be okay. Oh, you have your running gun back. Please tell me that doesn't take you through acid. God damn it. Of course it does. Of course it does. Yeah. Now, if we can take out that thin man, our problems got a lot less problem-y, if you know what I'm saying. The chrysalids are probably just going to focus on civilians, which is a shame. Damn shame. But we do have to focus on the shooty units, too. Okay. Yeah, we're going to stand out in the open like idiots, I think. Our rockets aren't going to be of much use unless Maseko can do something for me. Without killing any civilians, I don't think this is going to be a very reliable shot. It's also blocked, so it'll probably just hit Watson instead. That's just a bad, bad play. Yeah, it's blocked by the wall. That's... you're no good out there. Now, who can get this floater? I don't think you can. Let's see, that's from the floater. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, you wouldn't be able to make it up here, Deadeye. So you're gonna just have to take shots against something else, but what? Oh my god, I don't even think you can take shots against that chrysalid. You might have to overwatch that chrysalid. Maseko and Watson might have to take the chrysalid. You can't even take the chrysalid. Okay, well, we'll have to take out the floater with dead running gun. God, that's disgusting. That's something we gotta deal with. But can you see it? No, you can't see it? Ooh, that's even worse. Then it's up to running gun completely. Okay. Let's do it. We gotta take something out with this. Now, what's the best way to do this without running through that? So that's going to run me through the acid. I can't get cover, really. Well, I can't. Nope, that's acid too. It's all acid, man. We have to kill that thin man. We have no choice.
Rolling out.
It is acid all the way down.
I'm all over it.
Ay, caramba. Okay, I don't know how we're going to deal with that lid. That is just upsetting. But I know how we're gonna deal with this. Maybe. That's pushing it. That is pushing our goddamn luck. Yeah, I say go for it. I mean, Black Monk's not gonna get a better shot, and we're not gonna get a better reason to use this grenade. Ronan's not gonna be able to take that thing out. Did it blow up? It blew up, thank God. Okay, now what? Ronan, what kind of shots do you have? 43 versus another 43 with the shotgun and your pistol. These things are uncovered. 52, 65. Who is more dangerous right now? Who's more a dangerous foe? That's guaranteed kill. That's also a guaranteed kill. I mean, you do have CCS, so if that floater just stays still, which it might, you'll be able to shoot it, but you don't have covering fire. Who's more dangerous to me right now? And I don't even get me started on this thing. Who is more dangerous to me? Well, we do have a better chance to hit the thin man with the pistol, but that's not guaranteed to kill it. Is it? No. Rona might be in trouble if this thing gets wind of him too. Yeah, this thing's gonna have mobility to take me out. We gotta do something. Well, there is something we can do. It's not a good idea, and it might not even really work. But it might give Kelshmo an opportunity to shoot it, which is what we need right now. So Dale Watson might actually just want to retreat. Get away and fight another day. And then we fire the rocket at that wall, which will hopefully reveal the chrysalid. To Kelshmo, yes, okay. I like the plan more and more as we go. We'll just fire it right through that doorway. And then we pray the wall comes down. Come on, Maseiko. We can do this. Oh, yeah, we can do this. All right, Kelshmo. This is your calling. You're here to say you're taking up the rear. You're saving the squad. Hey, even the gunner can see it. Okay, you're going to shoot and you're going to move. Good work. You're going to shoot, you're going to move, and we're going to take these chrysalids down. Now for the problem up here. Well, I think men do suck. I don't know what to tell you. Even if we hit this thing and it doesn't die, then we have to take it out with Monk. I'd rather have a floater that might get CCS'd than... actually, how much ammo does Monk have? He'll have enough for that CCS. I'd give it to Ronin. Come on, Ronin. Yes! Oh, he just drops like a noodle. It is over. It's just two chrysalids now, whatever zombies come after. Yeah, Simon's, we gotta start moving you up to deal with these chrysalids. I don't know what the best place to do that's gonna be, but we gotta move. We gotta fight. And we are out of, HE grenades, so we can't blow up in that wall to take them. Gonna have to do this manually. Get out of there! Hey! Don't touch that civilian! Oh, God! Oh, jeez! Oh, disgusting. You bastards. How dare you. Alright, we're out of rockets. We're also out of time. We need to move. No more excuses.
Moving out.
These things need to go. Watson's still there with another grenade. That's good. We can take out another chrysalid. We can end this. Oh, God. God. Damn this smoke. God damn this acid. Oh, damn it all. This is apparently not dashing. Is it? It might not be. I think it is. It's dashing. This might not take me through the acid? I hate acid. I hate it so much. Yeah, it's going to take me right through the acid. Okay, let's put you inside the mausoleum instead. You'll still probably be able to see it. And you can even get a grenade off if you need to. Hey. We might even be able to hit both in that grenade. Or just focus our grenade on one. We know there's another there. And we need it to die. Damn this acid. That is just inconvenient for me. Yeah, we could save a sieve. That is just a pain in the ass. Of course. Oh, Lord in heaven, save me. I do not know what to do. Because that acid's just not a good idea to run through, especially with close-range chrysalids doing their deeds. Ugh. Gross. Well, I don't think we're going to be able to get it from here with... Maybe. Maybe if we're really clutch with the... Actually, you might be able to see it. From there. Oh, please be able to see it from there. Oh, yeah. Okay. We can hollow shred it. Very good. Maybe finish it with Black Monk. And then the other lid is just the problem. Good.
I need ammo.
No, we're not done. Don't let the silence fool you. We are not out of the woods yet. We need to get people up and on Overwatch.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Because that's the only way we're going to beat this thing. Now, I could throw an AP. It wouldn't do damage to that wall, though. Yeah, we're going to just have to deal with the Chrysalid's Wrath. I'm afraid. That AP's not going to do us any good. So we're going to Overwatch.
Come get some.
Either move up or Overwatch. I'm sure the crystal will come out to play.
I've got my eyes on.
Scout might be able to even get a view on it.
Heading there now.
Depending. I just hope it's not in range of any of my soldiers. I don't know where that thing is exactly. Oh god, scary, scary, scary shit. No, god, why?
Position confirmed.
Why you do this? Ronan, I don't know if I want to put your last shotgun shot on Overwatch, but we might have to. You'll be out of ammo next turn. We'll have to let somebody else deal with it.
Overwatching.
Come at me. Come at me. Well, are you gonna come at me or what? Oh god, zombies! Okay, that's new. That's different and exciting. Come on. We can't let this thing take another life. No! No! Stop! Please! No! Oh, god damn it! We could have saved another! God damn you! And let me guess, another zombie? Yeah, get out of here. You don't have the movement range. Or at least you goddamn shouldn't. That would make me very upset if you could actually get me.
Got no ammo.
Oh, well, we might actually not have to worry about that. Okay, we do have to worry about that. Oh, please, God. Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
I need ammo.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Oh, God. That was scary. Okay, we did need Ronan. Big time. Well, we also have grenades. Okay, so that's... If we can't deal with the crystal this turn... Oh, that's upsetting. That's upsetting. You don't have any ammo. You can't do anything this turn. I should have reloaded you. I should have reloaded you. I was a fool. I was a goddamn fool. Who's taking the chrysalid then? Who's got this thing? Maybe you, Dale Watson. Maybe you.
Moving to position.
How big are your balls, Dale Watson? You don't have any grenades. Only got an 80%. An 86. I'd go for the 80. Ah, damn.
Got no ammo.
Damn it all to hell. And you can't do anything either. Shit. Oh, we're in trouble.
I'm on it, Commander. You're clear. Go.
Well, at least we saved one.
Locked and loaded.
Ah, damn it. Fuck this. Ah, fuck this. Ah, fuck this. I mean, you'd think you could handle it, but you can't handle it. It's just so difficult. All right, Kelshmo. Take this guy for me, please. Good. Use the engineer to deal with the other one, and hopefully Black Monk to deal with the zombie. If we can't deal with the zombie, then we're in trouble. Then we gotta deal with the chrysalid. Oh! Oh god! You don't have ammo! Oh shit! Okay, well then you're gonna have to take out the chrysalid. With your pistol.
I'm on it, Commander.
You don't have ammo! Oh my god, how could I have not... How could I have fucked that up? Roman Grath doesn't have CCS either. Only Black Monk does. Might have been better to leave Black Monk. Oh, no. What did I do? What have I just done? Alright, kill it, please. Okay, good. He's up in the sky. He's dead. Damn, we're in trouble. And I just left you high and dry. We gotta kind of pray this grenade makes it, huh?
Roger that.
If it doesn't, well, then we're kind of boned, huh? I saw it. Right there is good.
Eat this.
Please eat it. Damn it! Oh, you gotta be kidding me. We're gonna take a hit from a zombie.
Moving out.
Oh, let's hope it goes for Ronan. Ronan's the tankiest. I'm afraid he's gonna have to take that hit. We have to kill another one, too, this turn. Oh my god, ridiculous. This is why I'm not looking forward to the third Terra mission. No, it's going for Simons. Oh shit, I'm sorry. Don't kill him. It's fine. It's good. Okay, it's fine. This is shitty, but it's fine. Oh no, don't you dare. Don't you dare. Get away from me. Get away. Don't touch me. Oh my god. No, don't hit Black Monk 2. You don't have range. He has range for that? Are you kidding me? No! Okay, wow. That was some good DR. You have range for that? Jesus, man! Ah, no! You little dicks. Ugh. Ronan, you gotta deal with this one. Black Monk's gonna deal with it too. Ronan's gonna deal with that one. Maseko's gonna deal with this other one. And we're gonna go home. Ah, jeez Louise. Well, at least they didn't go after Sivs. Ugh, get out of town.
Bye bye.
Get out of town. Ronan! Finish him. Finish this asshole. Yeah. Yeah. Actually, let's see. Black Monk's not even gonna go out. Oh, Simon's gonna be down for a long time. Damn it. God damn it. Damn it all. That's my fault. It had to be done. Oh, who's close to leveling? You already leveled. McGrath, tell me you got this. No, you, I don't know what to say. We needed Simons, man. That sucks. Oh, right, I need concealment. You need to finish this then, Dale Watson. Please do that for me.
Moving out.
Not one more. You will not take one more life from me. Oh, Jesus, I have to use the pistol. This thing's gonna tank it. God damn it. We needed these people. How could you? Give it to McGrath. Give it to McGrath. Monk doesn't even have any shots anyway.
Dead and gone.
God damn it.
Another day, another successful operation.
God damn it. We almost got out of there clean. And now a lot of people are wounded. Fuck zombies. Oh, the next terror mission next month is gonna be so bad. And Canada's panic's gonna just shoot right back up. And Watson got promoted. Good job, Watson. What am I gonna do with you? That's a different question. Maybe repair. For when arc throwers are a thing. That is a good question, but a question I will answer another time. 35 days, he's not coming on any missions. He's not coming on Confounding Light, and he's not coming on Gangplank. That sucks. Everybody, I fatigued everybody, didn't I? Oh, 16 days on Foxtrot, that's bad. I think it's the higher rank you get, the more fatigued, maybe. Watson's the only one not fatigued. Is that worth it? I don't think so. Oh, no! And
remember,
then I...
we will be watching.
Ah, crap. Crap. How long is that going to take? How long is that going to take? All right, that's bullshit. Oh, that's bullshit. Okay. No. Nope. No. No. No, that's not how this is happening. Okay, so it's the 30th. Council report is soon. Apparently it's in 2 days, but I don't believe that. I'm gonna go ahead and launch a satellite. Ah, that is bullshit. That is bull honky. We don't have an auto laser now. For 11 days? What? I thought it was supposed to be a fraction. Maybe it's because he lost all his health. I don't know how this works, seriously. Okay, well, we have to save Canada. We might actually wait a little bit on that. Ah, damn it. Ah, no. This is so bad. I want to back out, but I can't. This is Long War, man. Game over. Jeez Louise. Okay. That is bullshit. I don't know what to say other than no. I don't think I will do that. I think I'm just going to actually... I might change that. That seems a little too much. Like, you shouldn't have to both pay for it, and you shouldn't have to wait the full time it took to build it. That doesn't seem right to me. I mean, call me old-fashioned, but you're supposed to take a man out to dinner before you fuck him first, Long War. Okay, we're gonna make sure that we don't go past the deadline here. I think there is a 31st of May, but I'm gonna hedge my bet on the fact that there's not gonna be anything on the 30th, but if there is, I just screwed myself. All right,
satellite,
we're saving Canada.
At maximum capacity.
Now we're gonna go ahead and buy some things. How long does it take to build an autolaser? 14 days. I'm sorry. You're right. That isn't the whole time it takes to build the autolaser. How could I be so silly? Bullshit. Oh, that actually does make it better. I just need a few more allies. I need another laser cannon. That would be great if I could get that. And hopefully when that other laser cannon builds, I'll have exactly enough alloys. We need 22. We'll get there. We'll make it. And I need to buy another aircraft, too. I need money for that. Weapon fragments, engineers. Yeah, I'm running kind of low on those. A little bit. 5 days for that, Japan. Yeesh. I'm sorry, Simons. You went out like a hero, but you gotta just wait it out, I'm afraid. We gotta use our other we gotta use Savick now and McKenna now. They gotta fill the shoes. That is irksome. Oh, perfect. 4 allies. Exactly what I needed. Alright, build that other laser cannon. And then we should be good. We don't have any allies, we can't build anything else. But we can build laser cannons, by golly. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna buy another fighter when the month's over. And then that's whatever else we do with our money. Probably build a second lab. I want to start getting my research going real fast. And now this is interesting. I don't know if I want to do this or not. And I'm thinking I do, because having extra money would be nice. I'll be able to build some more weapons for myself. And we'll be able to see after the month ends just how much money we're going to have. But in the meantime, I think I am actually going to do this. Even though it's terrible, it's the only deal we've had for engineers in a long while.
The new engineers arrived this morning, Shen.
We are stocking up on engineers now. All right. Oh, right, the laser cannon build. Also, I should equip that on somebody, but who? Scarecrow would be a good candidate. He would guarantee those takedowns. But I'd probably want to put it on somebody who needs to get kills, too. I mean, that is a good idea. We just wouldn't have Scarecrow for 7 days, and we do need him to defend the fort. But in the meantime, I mean, I don't really have any other options here. Also, I want to start moving people. I'm going to transfer you here. We're going to go ahead and put a Stingray on the new interceptor we're going to buy. Hopefully, we'll be able to defend our satellite. If not, then we're just in a heap of trouble. Oh, jeez, not to mention if Canada doesn't even come back to the project. That would be really bad. How's Canada's panic right now? Canada is not looking great, but we'll be able to save it. If all goes well. Cool, we got a laser shotgun. That's going to make things a little bit better. Karina Kearns is back. Good, we need those assaults. Well, ours are out. Yeah, that's just ugly, but that's war. War is ugly. At least we have LeBron Durant coming back soon. He'll be able to fill Foxtrot's shoes for the mission she'll be missing. And, you know, we do also have to consider our specialists and Lance Corporals now. Maybe even order more rookies, too. I mean, June is going to be a very hectic month, if my other playthrough of Long War is any indication. June is just a huge clusterfuck. I hate you, Repaired Bay. You are probably one of the worst additions to this mod I've ever seen. Hey, Xenoneurology is going to finish too. What can you do? At least we don't have to scan for Exalt just yet. Alright, let's assign that research. Arc Thrower available for manufacture. Sweet. Now, the question is, what to do next? That's a good question. We could get into experimental warfare, which would give us some much-needed research into what I believe is... we could start going toward Gauss. And advanced body armor we don't have the alloys for. That's not a surprise, but that's going to take a while anyway. We could start doing autopsies. I don't know how to feel about that. We're not really at the point where we have VPT yet. Illyrium? Hell no. Alien computers? Hell maybe. Xenogenetics is something. Yeah. But in the meantime, experimental warfare is the slowest one. Besides the sectoid autopsy, I might actually start doing that then. So let's do experimental warfare. We'll worry about autopsies when we actually can build. Oh, right. Ooh. Well, now I don't know what to feel because I can start building my alien capture facility, can't I? Yep, I can. That's expensive too. Just about as much as a lab. But we need way more power for that. So I'll build a lab first. We gotta build our. We gotta build the access lift too. I might have to do that meld deal. Yep, that's just how it's gonna be. Jeez, so much thinking you gotta do. Okay. Once the month ends, we order another interceptor, and then we figure out what we're gonna do. All right, Council, take it away.
Incoming transmission.
Excellent work,
sweet,
Commander.
We kept Canada. Yeah.
This council is
yeah,
pleased
I know
to see
we lost a satellite,
continued
but
support of this project has been
we didn't lose a country.
Worthwhile.
So it could be worse.
We hope that your current successes only mark the beginning of an enduring effort to eliminate the extraterrestrial threat.
Yeah.
We will be in touch, Commander.
Okay. Now, we have money. We do have money.
The new engineers arrived this
morning,
Commander.
Let's use
We're
it.
Always glad to have more help down here.
To do that. And also build another access lift. Oh, I don't have the funds for it? No, maybe I do have to do the meld thing. Yeah, I do want to start getting power very soon because I want to get captures very soon, too. So, that's what we're going to do. Now, of course, even if we focused on research, we wouldn't really have much to do with it at this point. I mean, if we got experimental warfare, we don't have the alloys for Gauss. I'm really not sure what to say about that. Might be more valuable to do workshops. But that's a tough call. I think I'm actually going to dispatch the meld to get money. It's not that worth it, but it's pretty good. We're going to start our way down to these steam vents to get a lot of power. As for the research,
though
I know you're going to...
I do not
yeah.
always
okay.
agree with Dr. Shen. He has a point in this case. Now that we have the potential to capture an alien subject alive, we do need to construct a containment facility before we attempt to bring one in.
Yeah, we do. So if I had to change anything about this campaign, it would be not start in Canada. Start with lasers before phalanx, so I get the cannons. Now, I don't think there's anything else I want to build, because I don't have the alloys to build anything. Yeah, that's not going to happen. Not until I get those laser cannons back. So we'll let our money sink be the facilities we're building right now. And then we gotta scan for XL too. That should be, that's how much money. That's $25, I think. No, it's $50. So I need a few more dollars for that. But we don't have to start scanning until the 4th or the 5th. Probably the end of the 4th is when I'll scan. Karen Hartman's back. Good.
Complete.
Okay, what are we looking like in the aircraft department still? 2 days, 6 days for the Stingrays. We have 3 cannons. We're gonna have a very, very awesome scarecrow defending our skies with that laser cannon. Yeah, there's the terror ship. Oh, they're gonna try to hit me twice very fast, aren't they? That's fun stuff. Well, we may as well go see what it is. I mean, I know it's a terror ship, but you never know if it is actually a terror ship. It's large NOE. So if it's landing, oh, yeah, it's a terror ship. That's a terror ship. I'd be amazed if it did land. Yeah, it's gone. Now that's an interesting wager. 1 scientist for 9 sectoid quarters. Jesus. What is this? Okay. How are we doing in the scientist department? Much better than we were the previous month. 27 is pretty solid. Not solid enough, but pretty solid. Now what we want to look at is how much we have in terms of sectoid corpses. We only have 20. And we need 10 for the autopsy, I think. Yes? Yes. I believe it is 10. Let me check. And 10. So we want to keep at least 10 of those for when we get to interrogate a sectoid, if that ever happens, if we ever get that far. Phalanx armor's almost back, which is good, because we need it, big time. Battle laser, unfortunately, not back. But what you gonna do? You just gotta kinda take that on the chin, I suppose. If I said I wasn't gonna edit the innie, really.
Contact detected.
And a low medium, so that is, that's something. That's a scout for Shurzies. So we want to try to go aggressive with Kurosawa, take it down a lot, and then finish it up with Zipperdahl, or Zal. I don't even know how to pronounce that. I think going aggressive with Kurosawa is not a bad choice. Yeah, I would do it to soften her up, bail out when I've lost about half health.
We have
hopefully this thing
bandits.
Stays around long enough. We can't let this thing scout. We don't want a fighter
approaching
coming our way.
Target now.
Come on, you can do this. What is happening? What is going? Oh, right! I lowered interceptor times. Oh, abort, abort, abort. That crit, though. That's why it was taking so slow. I edited the innie so the interception times were the same, but they're not quite the same. Okay, that sucked. That was bad. That thing didn't even really... That barely even felt it. Damn these Phoenix cannons. Okay. We try again. Basically, it allows me a better reaction time, and I think it's a little more balanced, you know? Being able to react to being hit for half your health, like I just was. Disgusting. Come on. Ah, God. Come on, one more. Okay, we get up board. We're not gonna do it.
No joy here.
Unless I really, really, really want to screw my air game over. Because if I did that... I hate this game! I hate this air game! It's so gross! It's so gross! I don't want to touch it with a 10-foot pole, but I have no choice. It's so gross. It's disgusting. It is creepy, crawly, icky. Ah, God damn it. I mean, if I want to even have a chance at continuing the tactical game or the, I could kill it. I could kill it if I were lucky, but I'm not that lucky. I'm probably not going to kill it. I might not even catch it. I don't want to do it. I don't want to have my entire fleet out and then have a fighter come in and just mess up the United States. That's not what I want. But then again, I don't want a satellite hunter to come in and kill Canada too. So where does it end? Where does it end and where does it begin? We have another interceptor coming in a few days, but he's a green interceptor, so he's not going to do us much good. Ah, screw it. We'll try it once. We'll try one shot. If I go above half, if I get damaged above half, though, I gotta leave. If I get damaged, all I gotta leave. You gotta hit this right now. Hit it. Hit it one more time. One more time. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Disengaging.
Okay. You weren't gonna do it. It's too risky. It's way too risky. I can't go. I can't do anything. There's not I can do. That is unfair. That is unfair. That is unfair, and I will not have it. That is messed up. I can't do anything. I cannot stop them. I cannot stop them. I can't do that either. I can't stop it. I cannot stop it. Like even if I did, and then I'm losing the satellite again, and then I have to build another one, and it's just a never-ending cycle. I can't do it. I'm not going to do it. We have the Scarecrow back in 3 days, but that's not enough. I wish I could say I noticed the UFO was in a Wii, but I didn't. And now the consequences of my next decision will probably haunt us for the rest of the campaign. May this Twisted Air game have mercy upon us, and let us pray that the consequences of this decision are not as dire as I would hope them not to be. Please forgive me. We need to do some damage to it. I'm sorry, we don't have a choice.
We're in pursuit.
The air game is bar none the worst part of this game, and if I had laser cannons by now, we'd be fine. Okay. Gonna do that again? Alright, leave.
The bubble.
We got it down below half. That exploding is good. It shouldn't complete its mission. It should not.
Contact detected.
Oh, wait, it was NOE! I'm an idiot! Oh my god, we have a landed medium that I totally just shot for no reason. God damn it! Why am I so stupid? Ah! What did I do? How bad was it? Oh god, I'm such an idiot. Okay, well, 3 days, 4 days. It can't possibly be that bad, right? Okay, you get your stingrays on. Oh, we have a landed medium, and our A team is all exhausted.
Contact detected.
Shit, damn it, what am I thinking? Ah! This is why I'm not good at this game. 22 hours? Well, that sucks. All our A team is out. Watson's back. We could use him. He would be good on this mission. We have to just decide what we want to give him. But yeah. Yeah, that's a landed medium. Mm-hmm. And I shot it with a rookie that I didn't have to even shoot it with. That's a landed medium. That is a landed medium. Yep. Well, yeah. We have to do it. So I'm going to gear up a squad and we're going to do this thing. Yeah, so fun fact, we would have actually been completely... Everybody would have had a laser weapon if it weren't for that stupid repair time. Now, Harge has got to deal with an LMG because it does the same amount of damage. Even though that's not really the purpose of a will-to-survive gunner, I'm bringing the LMG for one very, very important reason. It's June, and we just got a landed medium, which means they're a month ahead on research in this particular mission, which also means they are pretty much guaranteed to have a cyber disc on this goddamn thing. So, I need all the firepower I can get, all the heat firepower I can get, and I really hope an LMG is good enough to handle that. I really wish I had my auto laser, but that's just not how the game is it? It's not fair. We have Mr. Clean's heat warhead, Sergeant Watson's Mr. Clean. I'm sorry, I'm blanking here, and I'm saying but I don't really even care. This is killing me. So yeah, we have Watson's heat grenades for that. We also have heat rockets, so any cyber disc we encounter should be easy meat. We only have one shotgun today, which might seem odd, but I'm giving Slime... I feel like we're going to get a lot of entrenched firefights. We're not going to be able to really handle that well. And until I get another alloy cannon or a blaster laser cannon? Laser blaster? Laser? I don't know what they're called. Scatter laser, that's what it is. Until I get another scatter laser, I'm really not feeling that confident in my ability to take down stuff with a shotgun anymore, especially with DR of cyber discs and whatnot. But hey, I don't know. I still have time to think about it, and I will definitely think about this mission because this is an important one for alloys and other. I cannot believe I did that. I cannot believe I attacked an NOE ship. Ah, that's painful. Well, okay, now I know what I have to do. Transfer you. Get out of here. Get out of here. You're coming back. Guess what? You guys are better for the job. Oh, kill me. Well, at least Blinker Kamala has... Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's the one that just I injured for no reason. Oh, we have two Blinker Kamalas. Didn't realize that. Huh. Let me just rename you to Beaker Van Pelt. Good job, Beaker. You tried your best. But it just wasn't good enough. Well, let's hope no satellite hunters come in 3 days or else we are pretty much kicked to the curb. God... Damn it, June. Alright, that's that. We go on this landed medium, and maybe we come back, maybe we don't. Hopefully we do. At least my A-team won't die, or most of them won't. Ah, Spider-Watson was so close. Anyway, thank you for watching. I will see you next time, and hopefully I'll get my head straight together. That interception was disgusting, terrible, and it only made the air game much worse. I may actually go ahead and edit the innie for a couple things. Namely, the repair time for... broken equipment, and also the repair time for interceptors. I mean, that is what advanced repair is for, yes, and next time I do a Long War campaign, that's probably what I'm going to start with, because it's clearly the most overpowered start you can have, or at least the most useful for me. But for now, I'm going to edit the innie, because this is really just frustrating, and I don't like to cheat, but I also am not... my integrity is not as high as some other players out there. I mean, I want to see what happens on the ground, you know? And if I get taken out because of the air game, then I'm just like everybody else because the air game is terrible.
Contact detected.
It's nothing new. Another person to die from the air game is not something I want to see. I want to see myself die slowly, painfully even. And I really don't want to see that either, but... You know, we don't have a goddamn choice. It might just be quick. Quick and painful. And also the whole satellites. Anyway, it doesn't matter. What matters is I have some deciding to do. And I'm gonna do it. So, thank you for watching. I will see you next time. Later.